Yours is only one further degree of insularity. You think this vacuous aloofness of yours is some sort of moral superiority. So did we, so did we. It won't last you 10 years if we go down. Do you think that our disaster will leave the Atlantic for you? Do you fancy there is any freedom of the seas possible beyond such freedom as we maintain, except the freedom to attack you? For 40 years the British fleet has guarded all America from European attack. Your Monroe Doctrine skulks behind it now. I'm sick of this high thin talk of yours about the war. You are a nation of ungenerous onlookers, watching us throttle or be throttled. You gamble on our winning, and we shall win, we shall win, and you will profit. And when we have won a victory, only one shade less terrible than defeat, then you think you will come in and tinker with our peace. Bleed us a little more to please your hyphenated patriots. He came to his last shaft. You talk of your new ideals of peace. You say that you are too proud to fight, but your businessmen in New York give the show away. There's a little printed card now in half the offices in New York that tells of the real pacifism of America. They're busy, you know. Trade's real good. And so, as not to interrupt it, they stick up this card. Nix on the war. Think of it. Nix on the war. Here is the whole fate of mankind at stake, and America's contribution is a little grumbling when the Germans sank the Lusitania, and no end of grumbling when we hold up a ship or two, or some fool of a harbor-master makes an overcharge. Otherwise, nix on the war. Well, let it be nix on the war. Don't come here and talk to me, you who were searching registers a year ago to find your Essex kin. Let it be nix. Explanations. What do I want with explanations?